So proud,
yes, so proud.
This is a picture of Mario De Biasi, who had a great success because it is representing the best side of the atmosphere that we were living in the post-war period in Italy. We were outside trying to find the way to rebuild Italy, to the reconstruction of Italy. So there was a wonderful spirit of creating a new nation after the dictatorship and to create a new identity of our country. So Zavattini, who was the most important theoretical intellectual about Neorealismo in the movies, said that one of the way that photographers should behave is to follow the victim, let's say, of the reportage in a way that you can be like a spy photographing what's going on in this moment. So what he did is to make an agreement with Moira Orfei, who was a circus artist, to walk in the city and follow her. She knew that he was following her on the bus, in the street. And but what he didn't know was how the people could react. And this one is a magnificent image because all the men in Piazza del Duomo, near Piazza del Duomo, turned their eyes to look at her. She was not a star. She was a beautiful woman. And all Italian men turn around. The Italiener drehen sich um is the translation of the title.
Yes.
And there is also the full sequence of this reportage, and it was published in the 50s, but became very famous. It was used also by the Guggenheim Museum when they had an exhibition about Italian art. This was the opening, the most important image for the invitation card and so on.
Showed before in Germany? Or
not in Germany.
Like, a show like this in Germany?
No. The show was seen in Winterthur near Zurich in one of the best museums we have in Europe dedicated to photography a few years ago. Then I gave a lecture in Frankfurt in the summer academy organized by Selina Lansford, so with a projection. But it's the first time that it comes as an exhibition in Germany.
Yes, and this is a very political show.
Well, life is political.
Yes,
I mean, this is the reality, and so this is political.
Yes, very political. After World War II, but it starts before, no? The neorealism starts before.
Yeah, the roots of realismo can be found in the 30s when under the dictatorship of Mussolini, he pushed a lot the use of photography and film as a media for the people who were illiterate. It was very important that he could reach for the propaganda all the people that could not read. So the images were the perfect way to send a message. So after the war, these tools, this instrument and this language of images was used at the service of democracy and the building of a new nation that should learn to stay together, because we were many provinces far away, but we didn't know each other. And photography and film were very useful to explain and tell what was the rest of Italy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, this is a very famous shot of a photojournalist called Secchiaroli. It was a demonstration in the street of right-wing young people, right-wing.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yes.
So the police needed to protect because they could have been aggressive. And this scene is symbolic of what was going on in Italy in those years, because building a democracy was not easy. So there was left wing, right wing, and especially there were the Christian Democrats, mm-hmm. who were supported by USA.
Oh, yes.
And thanks to USA, with the Marshall Plan, we were able to build a lot in Italy in terms of roads, especially bridges. And so that was a strong conflict. In fact, in the show I put a couple of images that were they explained this big fight between left, right and center.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And there is an image called Se voti comunista, voti contro Dio.
Mm-hmm.
So if you give your vote to the Communist Party, you are voting against God.
Shall we go to this?
Yes, I would like to get...
We would like to go to this picture she was talking about.
Yeah.
As political...
Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. So this is the one I was telling you. Mm-hmm. Chi vota comunismo, vota contro Dio. Mm-hmm. That's a funny story. So in those years there was really a social conflict, because the church was supporting the Democrats, the Christian Democrats, in a way that was far away for what the church should do. The Catholic Church should have stayed behind the scenes. Mm-hmm. But in Italy it was really a lot of discussion, debate. Mm-hmm. And actually then we had the movies like what's the title of Peppone, Don Camillo, that were explaining this conflict, which actually was not so deep because they were friends, but theoretically they were enemies.
Mm-hmm. And you are very exhausted about the crowd. They are very interested. All the young people around, not only, young people.
I'm not exhausted, I'm happy for this crowd.
Uh-huh. You are happy.
Yes, I'm very happy because I see a very different kind of audience.
Mm-hmm.
Any level, the professionals came that I know, friends, curator, famous photographers, but I see a lot of young people, a lot of journalists this morning and again this evening. So I'm so much happy for this success.
Yes, thank you.
Thank
very
you
much.
To you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you to you.
Yes.
microfono e lui filma. Il microfono e il telefono.
Yes, the microphone is there.
Yeah, okay.
Mm-hmm. And you speak Italian?
I do normally speak Italian.
Uh-huh.
I normally speak French. Yeah. And I normally speak English.
A little, also
maybe
English.
Maybe you also speak French now.
No, we.
I like French.
Do you?
English, so it's consistent.
Yes. Can we? Okay. We had to go a little bit closer.
Closer.
To this,
yeah.
To this photos. So.
Do you have some special question to ask me?
Yes. I only want to ask. You are always. This is your name. You are the collector of this wonderful.
Yes, it is.
How much photos?
2,000.
2,000 and yes. All in a case.
And 2,000 books also.
Of this
literature.
Of this
on photography.
Photography. Only this photography or?
No.
Also,
no. Well, we have
international.
Yes, we have. Well, we have the Neorrealism collection. We have the beauty photo done by foreigner photographers, mm-hmm. like Cartier-Bresson, Kappa, Klein, Liszt.
Oh, yes.
Uh-huh. That they have photography Italy.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have the beautiful collection of photo done by foreigner photographers around the world.
Mm-hmm.
So there are three main collections. Mm-hmm. The Neorrealism, the Italy seen by the foreigner photographers, not only Italian. And then we have what we call the beautiful collection of the photo, generally speaking.
What do you think about this? How is this a range?
The space?
No, a range and the space.
It's a beautiful space. It's a beautiful space for the photography because there's plenty of space between one wall and to the other one, so people can walk, not disturbing itself, to have a revision of the photos. And the lighting is perfect, and the public is perfect, and everything is perfect.
Very many young people.
Yes, lot of them. But even in Italy, even all over the world.
Yes.
There was an exhibition in Turin, in Bologna, during the last weekend, Arte Fiera in Bologna, and they had more than 75,000 people looking at that exhibition.
Wonderful.
And most of them were young people.
Mm-hmm. So can you say this? For me, this is such a great photo. Can you say something to this?
Yes,
these
are the miners.
Oh, mine.
Miners in Sardinia. Those kind of mines are closed right now because there are not more convenient to explore them. And that was a strike during the 1950-56. They closed the miners during the end of the 60 years. So it's a beautiful black and white. It gives you the atmosphere of those people, which mm-hmm. is natural. They are not colored, especially.
Mm-hmm. And this is the same. This is the same series.
No, because this is from Sardinia. This I don't even remember what they are for. This is not from my collection. See, this is historic archive.
Right.
I don't know where it comes mm-hmm. from.
And but the other one, can you say? Something
well, this is another atmosphere. The atmosphere of the bar, of the where people used to gather together,
mm-hmm.
and so it's with people that are singing the guitar. And this is also a barber shop. This is the barber shop.
Ah, yes.
See, uh-huh. So you see the seats, and salone means barber shop, and they used to stay together at the end of the day before going out home for dinner, I believe. Well, look at the eyes.
So, okay, thank you.
You're
so
welcome.
Much.
You're welcome.
We will
welcome.
Send it to you.
Yeah, thank you.
Did you say all what you are what you are thinking about? Yeah.
Sorry.
Important. What you want to say to this collection?
Did you say all what you are thinking? And did you say
well, yes?
All
no.
What
well,
is
I'm natural when I'm saying that this is a beautiful place, and compliments for the town.
Yeah.
But you imagine that I've been in Düsseldorf. I'm 77 years old.
No.
I came the first time in Düsseldorf.
Yeah.
I was 12 with my father after the war. We
mm-hmm.
were having a rubber factory making parts for the automobile Fiat.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And we came in Düsseldorf, Duisburg, Essen to buy equipment and machinery to do molding rubber parts. And I came with my father, so 60 years ago. Mm-hmm. More, yeah, 65 years ago.
So you are very familiar here in Düsseldorf.
Well, not very much, but I mean, it's a good occasion to come back.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But the truth, yeah?
Yeah.
That's the truth.
Yes, it is. It is.
Fine.
I promise you, it's true.
Very good.
So what he did is to make an agreement with Neorrealism, who was a circus artist, to walk in the city and follow her. She knew that he was following her on the bus, in the street. But what he didn't know was how the people could react. And this one is a magnificent image because all the men in Piazza del Duomo, near Piazza del Duomo, turn their eyes to look at her. She was